Dobry wieczór. Prezentacja będzie po angielsku. I employ around 400 people in 5 companies, 5 profitable companies in Krakow. I'm going to talk about my mistakes and save you a lot of pain and suffering, because mistakes really cost. In Krakow we have Angolia, and you all know what Polonia is. Angolia is these strange British guys who live in Poland, and that's Angolia. And this Angolian, as you've got in front of you, we're even on Wikipedia. The first thing you need to know about is yourself. My mother said about my cousin Claire, "Claire is far too creative to go into business." No, if you're going to business to impress your mum, forget it. Mum is not impressed. You need to have self-knowledge to go into business. My brother is an international best-selling author. He's the international editor of The Economist. My uncle has a statue in the center of London. My dad taught at Oxford University. So what did I decide to do? I decided to set up a stall in front of the Smok Wawelski in Krakow. It was really the only thing left. And to screw up in business, you just need to forget about some of these things. You have to forget about money. Forget about your costs, clients, competitions, product, process, or people. But people is most important. Here you see a happy Rudolph, the red-nosed reindeer. It says here all of the other reindeer used to laugh and call him names because he shot them. Now, the point is that if you don't know yourself, it's very expensive to find out in business. We've got Tina Turner here, self-belief. So, Tina Turner sang, "She's simply the best." For many of the entrepreneurs in this room, perhaps it's true that we're not Tina Turner. You can't just go into business because you believe you're the best. Fear of rejection. I hated it when people criticized my business ideas. It was horrible. I've learned to love it. It's much better for your friends to shoot down your ideas than to have that wonderful experience of setting up a lovely business with absolutely no customers. You have to get out. You can't be a lighthouse keeper. You have to get out there and deal with other people. And other people are really hard to understand. Start with understanding yourself, then think about other people. Other people are complicated. Other people have different values to you. Other people are different. Now, you don't have to like them. You don't have to agree with them. You don't have to have the same values, but you do have to understand them so you can lead them, so you can employ them and do business with them. Now, you have to be really careful about who you go into business with. It's not just don't do business with the mafia. That's obvious. But also, if the other guy in your business partnership wants to make a million zloty and retire, and you want to build a global empire, you're going to have a big problem. So what sort of people? You want party people, people who are fun to hang out with. However, not any party people. Think, it's not just that he drinks even more than I do. It's more than that. It's got to be people who will impress your clients, who are good to hang out with, and who are great kind of active people. Here you see a lot of very impressive logos, amongst some of them are Ralph's. And what I would say is that volunteering, people who want to do things, it doesn't matter what they do, just let them be the kind of active person who gets out there, who wants to do things. Now, it's a terrible thing in business to be the smartest guy in the room, because if you're the smartest guy in the room, you've really screwed up. For me, it's quite easy. I'm sure some of you are very smart, but if you sit in a meeting room with the guys you've employed and you think you're the smartest guy in the room, that's hard, and you have to learn to lead them. You can learn leadership my way, the hard way. It's dangerous, it's painful, and it's horrible. Learning by doing, learning by trial and error is the bad way. There's a much better way to learn leadership. One of them is helping people like Ralph organize Ignite or TEDx Warsaw, because if you volunteer, you don't even have the tool of money to motivate people. You've got to find other ways. Learning leadership is easy, actually. There are courses online. Be a volunteer, learn about leadership, and that way you can do it. Another thing, become well organized. Cambridge University, Winchester College, they didn't teach me organization. It's very simple. Every meeting should have a written who does what by when. It's really easy. That's organization, productivity, and you have to be good at problem solving. Another mistake, notaries are so boring. Company agreements are really dull, but read them extremely carefully. Don't forget to do that. And think, what happens if it all goes pear-shaped? What happens if it goes wrong? Very important thing, an EU subsidy is not a business success. The right route from your money, from me to give you money, is when you guys supply me with something that I want. And finally, in conclusion, I'd just say that a cool company is not a goal. A company that makes a profit is a goal. And if, like John Paul Getty, you can rise early, work late, and strike oil, and have fun, then I want to do business with you. Thanks very much.